Welcome. My name is Silvia Dominguez Martinez. I'm proud to be the program director of the Bachelor in Economics and Business Economics. In this video, we provide additional information about the bachelor program. A video cannot fully capture the whole experience of visiting our campus, talking to students, and experiencing Amsterdam. Nevertheless, we hope you find it useful when making your choice. Before we move to information about our bachelor program, let us first give you a snapshot of our beautiful campus, the place where you will spend many hours taking classes and studying. The structure of the video is to first give an overview of the program, then discuss what economics and business economics is, and we will finalize with some next steps. The structure of the program is as follows. The bachelor program consists of 3 years. In total, 6 semesters. During the first 3 semesters, all students follow a joint foundational program. This part provides students with core knowledge on economics and business economics. Furthermore, the analytical and statistical skills of students are trained. In year 2, at the end of the first semester, students choose between major economics and major business economics. A benefit of this structure is that you can postpone your choice between economics and business economics until the second year. This gives you the opportunity to experience the different courses and then make a choice for what fits your interest best. Another benefit is that you get a broad basic training in economics and business economics that will be appreciated by future employers. Next, let us consider the first year of the program. The first year consists of 6 blocks. Period 1 and period 2 are blocks of 8 weeks, while period 3 is a block of 4 weeks. In the large blocks, we have a mix of economics, business economics, and quantitative and analytical skills courses. In the small blocks, the focus is on academic writing in semester 1 and on research skills in semester 2. Quantitative and analytical skills are very important in economics. Therefore, it is important that you find mathematics interesting, as it will be an important element of the program. We offer a challenging program, so you must be willing to invest effort and time. Most programs in economics and business economics will offer very similar courses. A distinguishing factor of our program is that already in the first semester, you will be exposed to guest lectures and will start writing essays. The course Principles of Economics and Business 1 each week discusses a topic in the field of economics or business. So some of the questions that will be addressed during the course are, how do individuals make choices? How can you motivate people? How do firms operate? Each week, there's a guest lecture of a top economist specialized in the topic. These top economists are active in academia, industry, and governmental bodies. Furthermore, students are exposed to seminal papers in the field and have to write essays. This is the first step contributing to academic thinking and writing. We will now move to the second year of the bachelor program. As mentioned earlier, the first semester of year 2 is combined for all students in the bachelor. In the second semester, students choose a major, economics or business economics. The program of year 2 looks as follows. Finally, in year 3, you have a lot of freedom to choose. Let us consider the 3 available options. First, we offer the opportunity of an internship to gain practical experience before moving into the labor market. Second, you can decide to spend a semester abroad. The University of Amsterdam has many partner universities all over the world. Studying abroad gives the opportunity to experience another educational system and a different culture. Third, you can follow a minor. A minor is a structured program to broaden your knowledge. Some students decide to follow a minor closely related to economics topics. For example, the minor in sustainability and economics. But some students have very broad interests, and they do something completely different, like a minor in art history. What is important is that the first semester gives you the opportunity to choose what fits your interests. In the second semester, you follow specialization courses within your chosen specialization. Next, let me provide some information about what to expect in the different majors. The major economics deals with the use of scarce resources. It both considers individual decisions and decisions of countries, but also why government sometimes intervenes. We can distinguish two fields, microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics deals with individual decisions. For example, which study to choose, or on what to spend your monthly allowance, or how to adjust your consumption when suddenly the price of video games increases. But it also investigates government intervention in markets. Take, for example, Google. Google has received several fines for violating antitrust regulation. Google holds a dominant position in the market of search engines. Amongst others, Google has abused this position by preventing its rivals from placing their search ads on certain websites. Google's actions reduce the available information to consumers and therefore welfare. The EU regulation is there to protect consumers. Recently, also the US is taking actions against Google because the US accuses Google of illegally protecting their dominant position. Macroeconomics deals with decisions of, for example, countries. Some questions that are considered within macroeconomics are: when should the interest rate be reduced and when is an increase expected? What is the role of the European Central Bank in this? What does it mean that Europe has a monetary union? What are the consequences of import tariffs? Let me give an example with respect to the last question. The United Kingdom has left the European Union at the beginning of 2020. Until the end of 2020, a transition period is in place. During this transition period, the UK has to follow EU regulation. Within the EU, free trade exists between member states. However, what happens at the end of 2020 if the UK leaves the EU without a new trade agreement? Suppose that in 2021, I, as a Dutch citizen, decide to buy a product from a web shop located in the UK. How much will I pay? The price listed on the website? Or do I also have to pay import tariffs, making the product more expensive? But also for UK citizens, products bought from Dutch companies would become more expensive if import tariffs are imposed. Research has shown that the Netherlands will be heavily hit in case of bad trade agreements, as the Netherlands is exporting many products to the UK. Good trade agreements play an important role when trying to protect the competitive environment of firms. Next, let us consider the major business economics. Business economics applies economics to address business problems. The focus is on how firms decide about investment, financing, organization, and measurement and reporting of information. Within business economics, we offer three specializations. Let me briefly discuss these three specializations. Although I discuss them separately, they are interrelated. In the specialization accounting and control, the focus is on communication of information to external parties, the verification of information, and the use of information within the organization. But why are these financial reports of this financial information so important? Now, the reason is that it might have big impact on the stock prices. Let me give an example. Recently, Netflix suffered a decline in share prices after presenting the earnings report of the third quarter. One reason for the decline was that the number or the growth in the number of paid subscribers was much slower than the expected number, and this made stock prices drop. Hence, these financial reports can have a very important impact on the stock prices of firms. In the specialization finance, the focus is on financial markets, investment decisions, risk, and return. So the questions that are related to the specialization finance are: what type of stock should you invest in? Why is it good to diversify your portfolio? How do IPOs influence the prices? But also, when we think about Brexit, what are the consequences of Brexit for the location choice of companies? And here we see very mixed evidence. On the one hand, we have Sony, who has decided to move the European headquarters to a European Union member state. On the other hand, we have the multinationals who, like Unilever, who have decided to base their headquarters in London. So one of the reasons for the multinationals like Unilever to locate in London is that they want to benefit from being listed at the London Stock Exchange. Finally, in the specialization organizational economics, the focus is on motivating employees and strategic behavior of individuals and firms. So to give you some examples, so when should you have an organization and when can a market do the job? How can you motivate people to do the right thing? What type of compensation should you offer? As an example, let us consider Shell. An important problem is pollution. Many measures are taken to reduce pollution, but how do you make firms feel the need to become clean? One alternative is to reward managers of the firm for doing the right thing. In 2018, Shell proposed to tie part of the CEO's compensation to the reduction in emissions. A CEO whose compensation depends on reducing emissions will directly be hurt if he doesn't take actions. Therefore, he will be more inclined to invest into technology that helps reduce emissions. Firms can use the design of compensation packages to make CEOs do the right thing. Finally, let us talk about career perspectives. We offer a solid education in economics and business economics. We learn you a toolbox that you can apply in your master and in your professional career. Our students have very good career perspectives. After graduation, most of our students continue with a master. However, we see an increasing number of students who decide to go into the labor market and postpone the master until gaining some experience in the field. Any large firm needs a good economist, but also in governmental institutions. We have students working in PricewaterhouseCoopers, Willis Towers Watson, KPMG, the Dutch Central Bank, the Central Planning Bureau, in ministries, and many other organizations. Throughout their studies, students are regularly exposed to potential future employers. The study associations organize regular career events, giving students wide opportunities to interact with potential prospective employers. Furthermore, we often involve companies actively by offering guest lectures. With the skills that you acquire during your studies, you become a valuable asset for any large company or governmental institution. You can study economics and business economics at other universities. Why should you choose to come to the University of Amsterdam? Let me highlight four reasons. First, we offer a challenging and interesting program. Second, in the third year, you have a semester to follow your interests. Third, the University of Amsterdam has an excellent international reputation. And fourth, we have a very diverse teacher and student population. On campus, there are more than 90 nationalities. This makes our campus very lively. So what are the next steps? So the next step is to participate in an experience day. During this experience day, you follow a lecture and a working group. And this lecture and this working group will give you a flavor of what it is to study economics and business economics at the University of Amsterdam. So for now, I wish you good luck with making your choice, and I hope to welcome you soon in Amsterdam and wish you all the best and take care.